Hey guys, welcome to Unlimited Health. Let's check out this video called Thor the Broken God, okay? This was made by Fat Brett, okay? This video is about God of War Ragnarok, okay? And Thor the Broken God, I guess it's because in the game, in God of War Ragnarok, Thor is always like sad, depressed, fat, drinking all the time, and you know, so bad that you know, in the end, his wife, you know, messes with some other dude, okay, some dude that was a pig in the 2018 game. So you know, it just total cuck. They turned Thor into a fucking dumbass. But one thing is true, they actually showed us Thor fighting Kratos, which is probably the only thing ever we all want it, so which is why we accepted Thor from the, you know, Ragnarok game. But for me, it's like they turned Thor into a complete loser. Maybe that's his character in the mythology. Maybe that's why he's like that, because I don't know. But in the game, I thought he was like, dude, why can he ever overcome his depression? Okay, he died, but why is his wife cucking him by you know, you know, flirting with some dude at the end of the game? Like, what the fuck? And his wife is so beautiful. It's just very, it just makes it really hard to look at her flirt with someone else. It's like, what the fuck, you know? But whatever. Thor the Broken God looks like this video is going to be really depressing. It's 36 minutes. It's going to be a long ass reaction. This was suggested to me by one of my loyal subscribers. I don't know why he suggested. It's a very long video, and the game Ragnarok came and went. It's over, and I still have to do this reaction because he keeps asking me to do. So let's just do it. Okay, 3, 2, 1, let's go, because nobody reacted to this video. So if I react to it, probably gonna be good. Okay, so let's probably get all the views, whoever looks up the reaction for this. So let's take a look. Okay, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Thor the Broken God. Let's see what this video even is about. If I loved it, I will fucking subscribe to this channel and probably watch all his videos, react to all his videos, okay? So let's do it. 3, 2, 1, let's go. A very long reaction, by the way. Go grab popcorn, fucking everything, and let's get into it. 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Something that always interests me in stories is the difference between a character's actual presence and their narrative presence. Huh. A character's actual presence is how often they are actually on screen, whereas their narrative presence is how much that character affects the narrative, how much their choices and actions are driving the story, how often other characters are talking or thinking about them, how often they precipitate choices made by other characters. Huh. In God of War 4, Kratos is a character with a lot of actual presence, yeah, because he's on screen for the entire game. And he's a character with a ton of narrative presence too, because everything he's doing is driving the story forward. In God of War 4, Thor was a character with no actual presence in the story. Outside of a single post-game Easter egg, Thor never actually appears in the game. But by contrast, he has a ton of narrative presence. Throughout the game, we hear story after story about Thor, about his incredible feats in battle, his drunkenness, his destructiveness, and his violence. Huh. The world of Midgard, as Kratos and Atreus experience it in the present, was in many ways molded by Thor's actions, along with his father Odin. Thor and Odin are the ones who killed all the giants, who caused Jotunheim to seal itself off from the other realms, who sent Fae into hiding. Despite having no actual presence in the story, Thor's narrative presence is enormous. His past actions absolutely affect everything that occurs in the story, and players will develop a really clear image of Thor in their heads. We know that Thor is a warrior, perhaps the strongest warrior of all time, that he is incredibly violent and destructive.
I like how Thor had some cool ass moments where he's like, you know, knocking Kratos out, and some really badass stuff goes on when Thor is on the screen. But he's way too depressed, and I don't know. It's okay, I guess. It's okay at the end
kills
of the day.
Without mercy or compassion. Yeah. We know that he severely beat his own son Modi and blamed him for the death of his elder son Magni. So he's not just violent with his enemies, but with his own family too. We know he is a drunk. Stories about Thor in Norse mythology mention his drinking. He drinks truly godly amounts of alcohol. The amount he drinks in a single sitting would outright kill kill most people. Before Thor ever appears in God of War Ragnarok, players should feel like they already know exactly who Thor is, which is what makes the portrayal in Ragnarok so surprising.
And also, I kind of didn't like the fact that he's always, like, naked. Always naked. Like, bro, wear some armor. Like, cool-ass armor. Make yourself look like a fucking beast. Because you're so big, you should look like a fucking, you know, giant. But I don't know why he's, like... You know, naked
because,
and stuff.
For the most part, the Thor of Ragnarok is not that violent, destructive, merciless, compassionless, drunken warrior we've heard so much about. Instead, the Thor of Ragnarok is kind of submissive and miserable, stuck beneath the thumb of his emotionally abusive father, mourning the deaths of his sons, in domestic squabbles with his wife Sif, in struggling to overcome alcoholism. We get thunderous glimpses of the great warrior side of Thor, but they are short and fleeting. How do we explain this discrepancy? How do we understand this difference between what we've heard about him and what we see when we finally meet him? Were all those stories wrong? Were they lies or misconceptions? Was Thor always this miserable, broken man? I don't think so. I think all those stories we heard about Thor were absolutely truthful. There's enough evidence throughout the games to back them up. Thor used to be a violent and merciless destroyer who didn't care who he killed, a man who was happy to drink enough alcohol to drown a blue whale. That is who he used to be, but the Thor we meet in Ragnarok is a character in transition, a character in the midst of transformation. Something has happened to him off-screen. During the gap between the two games, he started changing. So, what was it? What happened to Thor? I think the answer to that question should be really obvious. Both of his sons are dead. Magni and Modi were killed by Kratos and Atreus in the last game, along with...
And he doesn't kill Kratos. You know what? They actually planned on killing Kratos, apparently. The developers said it, that they wanted to plan on... killing Kratos in God of War Ragnarok, but they scrapped it because that would not be great, you know. So Thor can kill Kratos, but I wouldn't believe it because Kratos is like he killed like a fucking entire universes of gods. I don't think he would die with just one blow from just a god. Okay, I don't think so, you know. But apparently they planned on killing Kratos, so you know, he killed his sons. Kratos killed his sons. So I don't get why, you know, I don't get why Thor doesn't take revenge. He's always like leaving him alone instead of killing him, which is another plot hole, becomes like a plot hole throughout the game. So
everything else, we also knew that Thor was a father, a terrible father. Just look at how brutally he beat Modi for nothing, but still a father, still someone who cared about his children. Parenthood, child-parent relationships, hard questions surrounding the right way to raise a child are so central to these two Norse God of War games. And Thor's story is all about those themes too. We actually saw Thor's initial reaction to losing his first son back in God of War 4. We saw it in how he beat Modi, who he blamed for his eldest son's death. Thor's first reaction to learning of his son's death was the same reaction he had to everything in his life. Violence. Extreme violence. And that violent reaction leads to the loss of his second son too. It's only because Modi was weakened by his father's beating that Atreus was able to kill him. The Thor in God of War Ragnarok is a Thor who has had to face the fact that his violence, all his choices, his whole life leading up to that point, it all led to the loss of both his sons. He's also probably had to face the fact that he was a bad father, that he raised two really crappy sons. Magni and Modi were selfish, greedy, didn't care about anyone but themselves, and they were weak, both physically and psychologically. Not only are Thor's sons dead, but his sons sucked. And it's at least partly, if not entirely, his own fault. What does a parent do in this?
But it still doesn't make sense that he never took revenge and killed Kratos. Nobody wants Kratos to die, but this whole thing where Thor wants to take revenge thing is already a plot hole because he never took revenge. And he's always like letting go of Kratos. And in fact, he joins hands... kind of like understands his point of view and, you know, goes against his own father and stuff like that.
Situation. What can they do? Interestingly, there's another example of a character who's also in this exact situation in the game. Freya. Her son Baldur is dead. And even when he was alive, he sucked. And both of those facts were at least partly her fault. So what does Freya do? Well, instead of confronting any of that, she gives herself entirely over to a quest for vengeance. As long as all her thoughts are consumed by vengeance, she doesn't have to think about the mistakes she made. It's very surprising to me that Thor didn't give himself over to the same kind of quest for vengeance. But Freya's situation is different in some ways. Freya is alone. She is without any family.
Freya is alone.
She is exiled from her home.
Exiled from her home.
Thor still has a tyrannical and overbearing father making all his decisions for him. He still has a wife who cares about him. And more than anything, he still has a daughter, Thrud.
I don't think she cares about him.
He still has a chance to correct.
And his daughter doesn't give a fuck. She's always running around with Atreus and shit. And, you know, his wife is like, as soon as he died, she was flirting with that dude that was a pig in the 2018 God of War. It's like really depressing to see Thor's life throughout the Ragnarok thing story, you know?
Correct his past mistakes to be a better father, to raise a better child. And that's why I think he makes a different choice than Freya.
Hey, you know what? It's not easy to get out and completely fucking change yourself in a second. Unless you have like a very twitchy personality that you make split-second decisions and quickly change. He's not like that. He's like every other human being. And I think, you know, it's really difficult to change. Once, especially when you're addicted to alcohol, anything, you know, basically addicted to any kind of dopamine rush, and you're gonna fucking have a problem, man. So you're gonna have to, I guess, kind of force it on people to change. As a family member, you gotta do it on your family members in a way to save them, basically. That's what I think, you know?
One of the most interesting aspects of Thor's character is that, at the start of Ragnarok, he's a character who has already hit rock bottom off screen, but he is also already in the process of picking himself back up, already trying to be better. We can see that in his sobriety. In his first scenes, we see Thor being tempted by but still refusing to drink, because off screen he's made a choice to be better, and he's sticking to that choice.
He's a god. If I was like Thor, if I was literally Thor or a god or something with a shitty fucking, you're a god and you're addicted to alcohol, I would be like, fuck this. I would pack my bags and go somewhere in the fucking Himalayas or some shit, Mount Everest or some icy rock, and start living there for until my addiction goes away, and also like kick out all the alcohol in my home. And, you know, come back, tell, you know, have my family around every now and then and stuff. Almost like prisoning myself, you know, put myself in a jail to avoid addiction, okay? To, you know, to avoid whatever is addicting to me. Pretty much, that's what I would have done. There's many ways to go about it. You just have to think a lot. You know, I guess Thor is not like that. He's very emotional, I guess, very reactive to every single thing. So it makes sense that he never took any radical decision that can change his life, you know?
He is really trying to be better and succeeding. Let's watch Thor's first couple scenes in the game. And as you do, I want you to remember the journey Thor has been on to reach this point. He is a father who lost his sons, who hit rock bottom, who had to face his mistakes, who has decided to be better, and who is now facing the man who killed his sons for the first time. All of that is going through Thor's head during this first scene.
Wow. Amazing. You know what, man? I was so excited for Thor to be such a badass, but he's only a badass as far as the cutscenes goes and as far as what he can do with his powers. He's not a badass as in his personality or, you know, his actions or anything. He's not a badass as a person, you know. He's a badass for the cutscenes, the way the game shows him, and that's it. That's what disappointed me a lot. And you know, and if I meet the guy that killed my sons, I would first have a decent conversation and try to understand why he killed. And then I wouldn't give a fuck. I would actually go and kill him right away. But he does that a little bit by, you know, like literally like taking him out into the sky and falling down somewhere else and start fighting him, which is pretty cool. But, you know, if I was him, I would be like fucking volcano. I would be fucking murdering. But, you know, we all love Kratos, so he never died, I guess. You know, this whole thing, the revenge thing from Thor, it's just not, it was not a good direction to begin with. Because now Thor is a loser, depressed loser, cuck, piece of shit or whatever. Always drinking and super fat and, you know, it just, he's just all sad. Okay, and he can't do anything, and the developers decided to not kill Kratos, which nobody wants to see. So this whole arc about Thor becoming evil and, you know, killing Kratos is taking revenge. Everything is useless. So they should have never have gone with Kratos, like Thor to begin with. They could have chosen somebody else, or maybe introduced Thor with some different kind of plot armor, plot stuff, instead of revenge. And failing at revenge and having his wife cuck him with somebody else in the end. You know, I didn't like Thor at all, man, honestly. You know?
Can I come in?
Can I come in?
I have mead.
Mead, I have mead.
You would not find me good company.
Oh, you will. Sure, you kill my sons.
Lots to talk about.
We got lots to talk about, son. Let's go inside before I kill you. But it's Kratos. I don't want to say those words. I love Kratos. Damn. And those crows are gonna become eavesdropping or something from what they were talking. And then Thor's father comes in. Okay, let's go. Nice place. Amazing. Epic shit. Okay. We all know what's gonna happen here. This is what a fucking fantastic introduction for Thor. Just such a cool stuff, okay? But, you know, I don't know. The whole arc of his character is understandable, but really unnecessary for me, I think. You don't need someone taking revenge on you and failing at that revenge when he's such a great character, you know?
You could have told me before I poured. Why are you here?
Why are you here? Hey, motherfucker, let me talk first.
Just being polite.
Being polite. I would have packed my bags and ran off if I was that addicted for anything.
You seem like a calm and reasonable person.
Huh.
Are you?
Are you?
A calm and reasonable person.
Are you a calm and reasonable person?
If the moment calls for calm. I'd say the moment calls for calm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I am.
For half a second,
cool.
Thor is exactly who you expect.
Fantastic.
The storm, the thunder, the lightning.
When some big god comes close, like comes as a guest to your shitty house, man, that's some epic level introduction. I mean, wow.
Cloak. the reveal of Mjolnir, and the expectation of a fight. Then the half second passes, and we see a very different Thor.
Epic fucking Thor. Introduction. Everything. You love all Thor of this, speaks. Even the fight
and ultimately,
in the beginning.
He doesn't have much to say. I don't think Thor wants to have a conversation with Kratos. He doesn't have anything he really wants to say to Kratos. He doesn't want to hear anything Kratos might say. He doesn't want to hear any explanations or excuses for why his sons were killed. Thor is only here for one reason, and that's to pave the way for Odin. He's just here to make sure Kratos is, in what I'd guess are probably Odin's words, a calm and reasonable person. Odin told Thor beforehand, make sure Kratos is acting like a calm and reasonable person. And if he is, then I'll come too. Thor is on a very tight leash in this scene. And as it turns out, he has been for his entire life. Thor is Odin's bruiser, his bulldog, his muscle.
Yeah, he's always been controlled by his father and... My God, dude, you have to have independent thinking at some point. You have to, like, pack your bags and say no, you know, and leave. Now, how can you be a slave when you are so powerful? I get it. Your father is 10 times more powerful or some shit, but you gotta fucking think independently. You're a god. You have a responsibility. You can do something really great with your powers. Take the fuck, like, there's normal people with no powers. You can go and help them. Like, literally, come on.
Thor kills things Odin wants killed, and otherwise Thor doesn't need to say or think anything for himself. Except that's changing. Like I've
that's
said
changing.
Before, Thor is changing. You can
Thor's
see it in
changing.
The way he sniffs the mead, clearly appreciates the smell, considers partaking,
and then it drinks like a maniac afterwards.
Next, let's watch just
it's
a
like,
tiny
what?
Bit of Odin's part here in this first scene to see
Thor's I get it, but still.
With his father.
Now, what you did to his boys.
Like, if your father is so controlling and acting like a fucking evil person, you gotta fucking understand that. Even if you don't think your father is evil, you should understand that whatever he's doing is coming off as evil. And you gotta distance yourself, not sit down and start drinking all over again and, you know, becoming your father's slave and then... completely fucking ruin your life like this. Come on. And then you died because you went against your father. You didn't see the red flags and then you went against your father in the end. And now look at you. You died. And your wife is cucking you. Like literally flirting with some dude out there. Fuck. Like really.
Self-defense. Dying is what we Aesir live for. And let's be honest, they were kind of useless. But Baldur, he had value. He was my best tracker, my closer. Yeah, his mind was gone, sure. But he had his uses, and now he's gone because of you. You follow me?
Okay.
You have a debt. You're no fun anymore.
What do you want?
What do you want?
Odin's behavior towards Thor is despicable in this scene. Throughout the game, Odin treats Thor worse than he treats anyone.
Come on.
Thor is so physically strong. Because Odin could never beat him in a fight. Odin tries to constantly beat Thor emotionally into submission instead. Odin has to be the one in charge.
What is it with these people that stay in this emotional barrier and never rebel against suppressing emotions from others? What is it with these people? I get it, you're innocent and naive or some shit, but you're a god, man. Especially for Thor, this doesn't really make sense. Why is he like this? I get it, you love your father, but come on. You gotta fucking feel free at some point. You gotta go out, open the door, go out, enjoy the view, and breathe some air, walk, and come back to your house. You're free to do that. Okay, or go away somewhere and tell everyone you will come back in a month or something. I don't know, just like almost like go on a vacation or something. Like, what is this? Really, do you need all... You need to get emotionally manipulated. Like, even in real life, a lot of people get, you know, kicked around and shit like that by their, you know, parents. You should listen to your parents. You should listen to your, you know, the elderly, okay? But you should not be mentally manipulated, Like, that's bad behavior. It has nothing to do with family. It's just bad behavior. You need to fucking start thinking different, okay? You need to feel free, at least for the first time in your life, you know? I just don't get it.
Shame and bully his son to do it. The way he calls Thor's dead sons useless right to his face is disgusting. Kratos hated those sons too. Kratos killed those sons. And even he doesn't...
You can argue with some of, like, your parents or something. Once you're an adult, I think you can argue with them and, try to find a peaceful ground and also find a good answer to all your problems. By, you know, arguments solves things, okay? It might be dangerous because you can get into fighting, but if you're intelligent, if you're smart, you will stop the fight and have a conversation, you know? But Thor here, for some reason, he's all emotionally beat up by his dad's insults and fucking, come on.
This gross about them, not to Thor's face. The way Odin tries to manipulate Thor into drinking, into falling off the wagon, into giving up his sobriety, that's disgusting too. If someone is trying to overcome an addiction to alcohol, and you start waving a drink in their face and accusing them of being no fun anymore when they're not drinking, that is truly despicable behavior. Especially considering this is...
It's obvious that Odin doesn't give a fuck about his family. He doesn't.
To be healthy and sober. But Odin wants Thor drunk because he's easier to control when he's drunk.
Hey, one thing I have a very big question, okay? What was inside that green scratch in the basement that he's, trying to solve this mystery puzzle, right? What was in that scratch? Atreus brings all the pieces of the mask and, when it comes to the end, he breaks the mask and shit. So I don't know what's in that scratch. Apparently it's like endless knowledge or whatever. But he's obsessed with it. But it's almost like he traded his love for his family towards the obsession over that green scratch. Okay, so I don't get it why he did that. Does he not love his family? What's wrong with Odin? Why is he this inhumane? I don't get it. Why is he like this? And I get the obsession with that green scratch. I also want to know what's in there, but I want to also, like, calm down. You're acting way too evil for this. Come on.
Odin doesn't care about Thor. He just cares about how he can best use him. Let's watch two scenes from much later in the game that further this point.
Look at this. We make a good team.
Yeah, look at that scratch. What is inside that scratch, man? I would like to know what's in there. It's probably like another whole world with a map full of enemies or some shit. I don't know. Like zombies? I don't know, man. But there's something in there. I want to know what's in there. What's the mystery of it? I want to know.
Don't we? Make a good damn team?
Just like you and Baldur.
You both behave out there?
Thor was really great. I learned a lot from him.
You learned something from him? Really now? Okay. What did you teach the kid?
Nothing. What could I possibly teach him?
Come on, Thor. You can... Look, he can talk back to his father, but he doesn't want to fucking rebel against him or get away from him just for his own safety. He can't do it. I don't know why.
What are you going on about?
I just don't get it. The mask, bringing the giant...
It's perfectly human to say no. Come on, man. Why is Thor so depressed? Unnecessarily depressed. I just don't get it.
Stop letting your wife think, boy. She's clouding whatever's left of your brain.
This isn't about her.
No, okay. It's about your limitations. Accept them and move on. Now go smash something, will you?
Honestly, oh, like, man. Wow.
Come here.
And why does he keep, like, these lines of conversation? It's just a loop for his depression. He just keep listening, having these conversations. It will only keep make him more depressed. Just get away from this corrupt dude. That's your father. Just stay away from a while, okay? You don't have to leave him, abandon him or anything. Just leave. Just go away. Does it matter? Just fucking leave, man. What the fuck? But like Odin comes back and goes back in search of his son Thor and brings him back to this place or something. Is he can never escape from him or something like that? Because that I guess that makes sense, but fuck.
Odin relentlessly insults Thor's intelligence, belittles him, shames him, laughs at him, and tries to make him feel stupid in these scenes. It's truly disgusting behavior, and it works. Notice the way
Why does it work?
God possibly teach him? I think Thor really believes that. His father has spent his whole life convincing him that he's stupid, so he really believes that he is stupid, that he has nothing to contribute, that he couldn't think for himself even if he tried. Also notice Odin.
So it's like since he was a kid, he was experienced. This fucking bullshit from his father has become his whole world. That's just so fucked up, you know. I would say go have some adventures, meet new people. You know, they'll become friends, and then you can have a different perspective, and you can probably even say something to someone and teach them. If they're naive or innocent, you can teach someone whatever you learned from other people. And, you know, you can grow as a human being and come back to your fucked up father. You know, it's not a big deal.
I liked you better when you were drunk. Odin is not only belittling his intelligence, but still trying to push him into drinking again, which also works. Thor does fall off the wagon after this. He does go back to drinking, and I'm sure Odin is delighted by it. He wants Thor drunk and dumb so he will never become a threat to him. Let's go back to that first scene, though. When Odin's manipulations fail to work on Kratos, he sicks Thor on him.
Man, if only Kratos knew. Like, if one thing I don't understand is that Kratos can kill all these gods. Why can't he do something good instead? Like, you know, save the world, help people. You know, you can kill gods. Like, literally, you can help some people. I get that you killed a lot of gods because you had your own mission, but now it doesn't seem like that is a, you know, problem. You're done with that, right? So you just want to be left alone, but you can still help people, you know, do something like that and help Thor instead, you know, do something like that and kill this bitch called Odin. Why don't we just end him before he even shows up at your fucking doorstep? Like, really?
And have some time alone to manipulate Atreus instead. And finally, we get to see Thor off the leash. The true Thor. See what he really wants to say to Kratos.
Don't take all day.
About time.
Oh! Man!
Waiting for this. You're not from here. We got a tradition called a blood payment.
Wow.
It means I get a piece of you for what you took from my family.
You'll pick it up. Damn!
That was for Baldur. Now show me this god killer I've heard too much about!
This battle is spectacular. The cinematics, the epic quality, it is just awesome.
Epic
shit. It's not
a
difficult boss fight, but in terms of cinema and drama, it is up there with some of the best in the series. Here we finally see the Thor we heard about in the previous games. The great warrior, the violent destroyer, the merciless killer. He's very powerful. He actually kills Kratos at one point during this fight. It's not that extraordinary, since Kratos has died like 5 times over the course of this series, but it still goes to show just how strong Thor is. One of the few opponents Kratos has faced who have the power to defeat him. And it demonstrates how much control Thor has over this fight. He can kill Kratos and restart his heart at a whim. This is Thor at his most content and most powerful in the game.
Fantastic.
Thor lives to fight. He lives for battle. He says he wants a blood payment from Kratos in exchange for the killing of his sons. You'd think that would mean blood for blood. In exchange for killing my sons, I kill you. But that's not what Thor wants.
Or kill your son.
Not yet. All throughout the fight, he keeps saying to Kratos, stop holding back. Show me your true self. Show me your power. Show me the god killer who killed my sons. I think Thor...
Oh, you would not know what Kratos can do to you, Thor. Fuck, you don't know. You don't know Kratos, okay?
Wants one last really good battle before the prophesied end of Asgard. Some of the only interests he has in life are blood and battle. He doesn't have hobbies. He just wants to see a truly great warrior in action at his peak. The blood payment he wants is seeing that god-killer side of Kratos. And when he gets it, he's satisfied, at least for now. Let's fast forward way ahead in the story to when Atreus journeys to Asgard. Odin tasks Atreus with gathering fragments of this mask, and to help out, he sends Thor with him. I find this whole section of the game to be fascinating. I know there are some people who find the Atreus sections of the game to be boring, but from a story standpoint, they are all super compelling. Sticking these two characters together, letting them speak to each other and bounce off each other, was a really smart decision by the writers. There's so much fertile ground for conflict and understanding between the two of them. There's this moment where Atreus asks Thor, "What do you think?" And Thor just says, "Do your job." That's Thor's whole life. That's what Odin has molded him into. Don't think, just shut up and do your job. Atreus confronts Thor over the slaying.
I get it. It's like ever since his childhood, he has been like brainwashed into behaving like this, into like listening to the rules and never say anything. Bro, but you still gotta like, hey, let me go out there for an adventure. Let me meet someone new. And not show my godly abilities and act like a normal human being in front of other human beings. Let's try to do that because I'm kind of bored or something like, just because you're bored. Why not do something else other than just being, a slave to your father's demands? Why can't just, be, hey, I could go out there, you know, I'm bored, you know, just go out there, learn something, do something else. You know, and you can come back to your family, no problem. That way you will see the difference between reality, other fathers, people that have fathers, other fathers, their kids, and yourself and your father. You will see the difference, right? It's not, you cannot just be in a one-dimensional state. Like, come on.
...of the giants, and here we get a little glimpse of the old Thor, the merciless, compassionless killer, when Thor responds by saying, "I reveled in their deaths." We see it again when Thor beats the Surtur Trials, and he boasts of the rivers of blood and mountains of corpses he left behind. Thor also keeps repeating this phrase, "Don't try to play me," threatening Atreus if Atreus tries to trick him. I think this reveals an anxiety Thor has. He thinks he's unintelligent, and he doesn't want to be tricked and manipulated, doesn't want his intelligence used against him, which is ironic since it's Odin, his father, who is really the one manipulating him. And Atreus even manages to get Thor to trust him, at least a little bit. The next time, Odin sends Atreus and Thor to find a mask.
But they never delved too deep into this relationship and made it a big plot point or a theme of this the game or anything like that. It's just all we see is him drinking, sad, and very rarely you see some scenes of Odin belittling him and insulting him, not even that hardcore or anything. It's obviously like he's depressed with his father's attitude, but we never see him and his father have an intense, you know, father intent, like really hardcore bullying, almost like belittling him, insulting him, like really hardcore shit. We don't see that from his father towards him. So we only see very minor, just a little snarky remarks, and him leaving the place to go out there and drink again. You know, that's all we see. We don't really dive deep into this Odin and Thor dynamic. So it's never the theme of the whole game. That's why I think this Ragnarok game lacks a lot compared to the 2018 God of War. You know, it lacks so much. Instead, it wants to spend time with Atreus and this little Thor's daughter. Stupid fucking love triangle or whatever it's going on. Instead of that, you could have shown me this. This is a fantastic theme to follow throughout the game. But they don't deep dive into it. So fuck this.
Fragment. You know? We find Thor in this tavern, dead ass drunk. He's fallen off the wagon, failed his sobriety, failed himself, and failed his family too. Let's watch a bit of it.
Right where I thought you'd be.
to be here. You shouldn't be here.
And his daughter is way too fucking overconfident, over, you know, like super. It's like she knows better than everybody else. That's how she acts like. And bitch, you're a little bitch. You're shorter than Atreus. Shut up. Okay? I hated her character. Thor's daughter and it's like her, and Thor's wife is a big, cheating, cuckolding bitch by the end of the game. And I'm like, fuck that, you know?
You shouldn't have brought her here. Hmm.
What are you doing?
Relaxing.
Did I say no rush? I meant we should get going.
Get going. Right?
We don't want to keep the Allfather.
Quiet!
He's right. You should get going.
Man, get out, please. You suck. Everything sucks.
Dad. Don't do this.
It's already done. Let it be known, the God of Thunder is good for two things. Killing giants and pissing me.
Okay.
Any man who disagrees will greet Mjolnir with his face.
I don't know. Does the MCU Thor apply to this real? Is to this Thor? Because if MCU Thor did this kind of shit, I would expect like the hammer to leave him because he's not worthy. But here it's like the hammer stays with him. But also in MCU, the Thor gets fat in there too. So I guess the hammer doesn't give a fuck about how bad he is, how fat he is, and drinking like a maniac, you know. He doesn't care about moral qualities, I guess, you know. I don't know.
This isn't you.
Thor comes off as totally pathetic here because he's a drunk loser. To be fair, there's really no other kind of drunk. Drinking turns you into a loser. As someone who has definitely drunk a lot more than I should have in my life, I feel very comfortable in saying drinking turns us all into losers.
Dang.
This is what Thor was fighting. Fighting against becoming this person. This is who he didn't want to be anymore. And it's who Odin wants him to be. In some ways, this scene serves as an indictment of Odin as a father. Odin cares so little for his son that this is who he wants his son to be. A drunk loser. Miserable. Pathetic. Notice when Thor says, the God of Thunder is good for two things, killing giants and pissing mead. That's what Odin wants. A Thor who only ever does those two things. Kills who he wants killed and gets pissed drunk all the time. This is who Odin wants his son to be. That's how bad of a father Odin is. Next, let's watch how this scene ends.
Get up.
It would have been a very great character study. You know, it would have been such a great character study
to
see Thor's story, you know?
You have to get up.
We could have gotten such a great story by showing Thor and his fucked up life with his father and how fucked up his father is and everything. You could have seen it in a much more closer detail. But instead, it's only remaining to like a few lines, few cutscenes. And then most of the time you're spending time as Atreus going around with this little bitch, and it's just so annoying. Okay, the game is just almost like I felt like I should give it a 7 when I was playing as Atreus. It turned me off so bad. I only gave it like a 9 or 8, and I give it 9 because it was a new release, a new game that came out. So it's like the sequel of God of War. So I gave it a 9. For me, it's 8, man. I want to go down to even 7, but I don't want to because the gameplay and everything is even bigger and better. So I was like, okay, you know.
I know you're disappointed.
Disappointed? No. That was a glorious fight.
Why is she overconfident? And I hate this.
You can't even say you're sorry this time, can you?
This Throod character. She sucks, okay? What's with the teenagers in Hollywood movies? They can't write good teenagers? Like, I just saw Last of Us TV show, HBO show, and Ellie in there was overconfident, over, like, super happy, super aggressive. She's like, she was acting like a bully, and it's like, Hollywood can never write good teenagers, good kids. They can never write. It's like, fuck me, man. That show turned me off. It's, and this bitch here is also turning me off. Like,
Grandfather
geez.
Treated you like crap.
And they act like a fucking adult every time they talk. These teenagers in Hollywood movies and or games or whatever, they talk like adults. I don't know why. Did you see Stranger Things? Like, I saw the first season. I stopped it because all the teenagers, especially that bitch, that white bitch, was like kissing and fucking everybody. Like, it's just so annoying. These teenagers act like adults, and they... I don't know why Hollywood shows them like they're mature adults. I don't get it. Okay.
We're struggling. I get it.
You were struggling.
But you can't just... We're here for you. Mom and I are here for you. Even when you're here.
Okay.
We love you. You know that. I just thought this was behind us.
I fucked up.
Again, you're depressing him again with the fucking...
You fucked up.
Yeah, and then you're gonna leave like this? Bro, if I was his son, if I was his son, I would grab him. I would take him away somewhere else. You know, I would pack his bags and take him away from this fucked up place. Okay, this is a fucked up place. His father is a fucking joke. I would have taken him away and lived with him and taken care of him, made him a better person and brought him back if necessary, you know. I wouldn't have tolerated
Thor
this.
Thor is trying to be a better man and father, trying to overcome his alcoholism, because he has a family who genuinely cares about him, and he wants to be better for them, even if he's failing now. I know I keep talking about what a piece of crap Odin is, but goddamn, it is so gross that he is actively trying to push Thor into being a worse father to his daughter, despite how clearly desperate Thor is to be that
and then he dies.
Father for her.
His father kills him.
Ashamed and humiliated in this scene. Take it from me, the only
disgusting
thing worse than being a drunk asshole is realizing that you're being a drunk asshole in front of people you care about. People whose opinions you care about.
I get it.
People who think less of you now. Pathetic is a hard thing to be in front of your family. From here, Atreus and Thor set off to find another mask fragment.
Another mask fragment.
As they do, they have a bit of a heart-to-heart. There's this moment where Thor says, I don't even know what you're trying to do
And
anymore.
Atreus never tried
no
to, you know, talk
through.
Sense
and
to
Atreus
him?
Is like, actually,
I guess he
yeah,
says something, but he doesn't.
We do have things.
He won't listen, or what?
We are both half giants. We both do have overbearing fathers from whose shadows we cannot escape. We are both struggling to forge our own path. Thor says, What's the point of talking about things we can't change? And Atreus responds, Who says we can't change them? And the answer is, Odin. Odin has spent Thor's entire life convincing him that he can't ever change, that he should always just be a drunk loser. Kratos and Atreus are offering Thor another choice, another path. You could change. You are smart enough to make a different choice. You don't have to be Odin's whipped dog forever. Now let's watch how this one ends.
It's here.
The final piece of the mask. Oh!
Gotcha.
Phew. That was close. Thanks.
Wasn't about to lose that.
Loki, you did it.
You did it.
We are on the verge of great things. All of our work together.
You're welcome.
I'm sorry. And
there she is.
You are here. Why?
His father murdered Heimdall.
Thor's cucking wife.
No, leave him alone. I command it.
You said no more Aesir blood would be spilled. You said family comes first. You don't think that this is retribution for him being here? He's put your granddaughter in danger. He's made your son miserable.
Loki didn't kill Heimdall. His father did. Your daughter is old enough to make her own mistakes. And your husband started drinking again all on his own. Dismissed!
No, you pushed him into drinking.
You too.
Fuck you. And what's the point of seeing this bitch? She's gonna cuck him in the end. I don't care if she's dead. You don't move on someone just because they're dead. Come on, what is this? What is this, a game? Like, really?
He's not protecting us.
Some people move on over people that, over husbands or wives dying. They move on with somebody else. What? That's just fucking stupid, okay?
Magni, Modi, our boys. We used to tell them stories by the fire. Do you remember? We would carve those wooden horses. We would play and laugh until the sun sank and they fell asleep in our laps. They were thrown at the Allfather's problems like brittle knives to a mountain face. And for what?
Yeah, he only realizes in the end. If he can realize his mistake in the end and go against his father, why didn't he do it in this situation or in the beginning or in the middle somewhere? Like, what is this shitty arc? Nobody will like Thor in this game, honestly. I don't think even you like Thor in this game, man. Really. Just to rub it into our faces that he's depressed, they're doing this. Like, come on.
You
kill my son.
Okay.
Sleep in their beds. Turn my father against me.
You don't. My daughter. Fuck your father, bro. Like, happening. I'm not saying you have to hate your father. Everybody loves their fathers, okay? Everybody loves their family, their parents. You should. It's very important. But man, when it's not about your father, it's about who is a, like, fucking making you depressed all the time. Who is belittling you? Who is, like, bullying you? Who is making you drink again? You need to distance yourself from them. Come on.
Oh, I finally thought of something I can teach you.
Hey, you stand down!
Something better be right. Where did you
go? Oh! Damn.
Sindri. You sure know how to plan an exit.
First, you notice how Odin completely ignores Thor at the start of this scene. Atreus was only able to get the mask with Thor's help, but Odin doesn't even acknowledge Thor's presence, and instead gives Atreus all the thanks. It's like Odin doesn't care about Thor at all. It's unfortunate that Sif gets so little screen time. The little we see of her, she seems like an interesting character, but I think she needs a bit more development. Sif is identifying the right problems here, but coming to the wrong conclusions. Odin is the one making Thor miserable, the one who pushed him to drink again, the one putting Thrud's life in danger. She's right that Odin isn't protecting them, that he sent Magni and Modi to their deaths, that Thor needs to stand up to Odin. But Thor going after Atreus doesn't solve any of those problems. The person Thor needs to fight is Odin. But I don't think Sif has quite realized that at this point in the story. And I don't think she's realized yet what kind of person Atreus is. So she and Thor both make a mistake here. We don't see Thor again until the final battle. Thor and Kratos fight, and throughout the fight, Thor is fully giving himself over to his old self, to that old merciless and compassionless warrior. He says, no more talking, no more games, I'm gonna kill you all. Of course, like every other god who's ever confronted Kratos, he loses. But that's when things get interesting.
What the fuck are you waiting for? Your daughter. My son calls her friend. If you try to hurt her, I would not.
you know what I've done?
Yes!
Fuck this.
But what will you do now?
What will you do now, bitch? Stop being depressed all the time. You fucking... And then you die like nothing. What the fuck? What a shitty door.
Destroy us.
No more.
No more. You're not destroyers. Learn your place, more. You little bitch.
For the sake of our children, we must be better.
That's right. Something you couldn't do. You Thor, you bitch. Fuck you, man. You suck. You stink throughout the whole Ragnarok game. I hate your character. Anybody could have been better. Like, fuck me.
Why isn't he dead? Are you talking? Who told you to do that? You don't talk. You don't think. I think you kill. It's a
my ass.
Fucking concept.
Fuck you, you little bitch. Should have fucking ripped his head off right at the beginning.
I just didn't want to see it.
What is this?
Yeah.
Are you broken? I am your
no.
father.
He's not a fucking mindless robot anymore, you fucking bitch. I hope somebody decapitates you. And that's what happens. Like, you know, they fucking put him inside like this thing. And then the fucking, you know, Sindri or somebody just breaks it. And good job. You're like a fart in the wind. You're over. I wish that that happened right at the beginning or something. Like, this whole arc of Thor, I cannot stand it, okay?
Take
it's ridiculous.
Take the hammer and kill who I tell you to kill!
No.
Down! Oh, and you're dead! Were you not ready?
I did not want this.
Okay. You just found out that your dad is a fucking stupid piece of shit, and you were ready, and you finally said no for the first time in your life, and then you were not ready when he was getting ready to stab you. Like, what? What is going on, Thor? What the fuck? And, like, come on. Really, just...
Rude. This was all their fault.
And his father can kill his son and in an instant like that? Is that true? Can Odin kill his father in a fucking second like that? I don't know. That's way too fucking crazy.
They've done this to us, to our family.
My ass. You don't give a shit about your family, bro. The people that you're confronting give a fuck about your family. That's how fucked up you are. Like, really. Look how he beats his granddaughter. Fuck this.
Looks like I gotta do everything around here.
Yeah, let's go. Oh, everything around. Get the. He's the kind of dude that fucks many people and gets, give births to many kids and then pisses off and leaves them alone, abandons them, and makes another family somewhere else. And abandons them and goes somewhere else and makes a family over there and abandons them and goes somewhere else. That dude is... He can change his family a dime a second, man. He can fuck everything up. This is not a family guy, okay? This Odin dude, he's not a family material. I think he only had a family because he wanted someone to help him out. That's all it is. He wanted someone like a fucking mindless robot to follow his orders, basically, because he didn't want to be alone. And also, like, the game even makes a point where it shows him committing suicide with a noose, but he failed or something like that, and the noose is still there on that tree, and Freya actually grabs that noose later on, and it shows, like, he didn't want to commit suicide, so he needed somebody like soldiers, like robots, to follow his orders. That's why he had all this family, his son with grandsons and everybody, granddaughter, everybody, okay? That's the only reason why he has a family. End of story, basically. And fuck this guy, okay? Fuck this.
He puts into words his entire emotional arc from the previous
Odin is
game.
A piece of
For
shit!
For the sake of our children, we must be better. This is the entire plot of God of War 4. This is what Kratos struggled with for that entire game. He had a monstrous and violent past, and through struggle, through growth, through parenthood, through compassion, he learned to be better for the sake of his son, learned to make a new choice. Kratos is offering this growth to Thor, offering him the same lesson he spent a lifetime learning, the same new choice he himself has discovered. If Kratos can
they could
be
have focused on
Thor,
and we know, you know, Kratos's life versus Thor's life,
he wants to
and
be
they
a
could
better
have
father
you know
to
become
Thor.
Friends.
You know,
they didn't even focus on that shit.
Of his mistakes. And for
all they focus
reasons,
is on Atreus and his love triangle and some scenes with Thor and his father. That's it.
Notice Odin's words here. You don't talk, you don't think, I think, you kill. Odin is putting into words his entire relationship with his son. I think, you kill. You just shut up and do what I say. You don't think about the moral or ethical consequences of what I tell you to do.
What's fucking mind-blowing is that Thor just, it right at the ending of the fucking game, that's when he realized, he says, Sif was right about you. And finally says, no. Bitch, you didn't think of this before all this shit happened? Like, you could have ended the whole story if you realized this shit right at the beginning and fucking decapitated your fucking bald father. Basically, you could have done that right away, but no, instead, you could have gone, you could have made your life better, you could have had more kids with your wife, but instead you died and your wife became a fucking cheating cunt. Cucking you in your afterlife. Jesus.
The consequences for your family of what I tell you to do. You aren't even human. You're barely more than a dog, a rabid animal for me to sick on my enemies.
Okay.
And then that line, are you broken? Which I must say, the voice actor
are you broken?
Delivers perfectly.
Bro.
Odin sounds so
you broke him
perplexed
a long time
there.
Ago.
You talk about like a calculator that isn't giving you the right answers anymore. What's wrong with this thing? Is it broken? This is not the way you talk about a person, and it's definitely not the way you talk about your own son. And then Thor says, no. This moment is the fulfillment of all of Thor's growth over the course of the game. In some ways, Kratos had it easier than Thor does. All Kratos had to do was make a new choice for himself. Thor has to do that, and he has to stand up to his father on top of it. Because Odin cannot stand not
and he dies
control,
like nothing.
Because he would rather his son be
look
dead
at that.
Than
he dies so
control,
fast.
He immediately and without hesitation.
I don't know if I can believe that.
Son.
He actually managed to fucking knock out or kill Kratos and revive him. And he dies like that? I don't know about that, man.
I've seen some people say they are disappointed by this death, because we don't get to see Thor really live his new choice in the way we've gotten to see Kratos do. But remember that Thor is a father. His choice will live on in his daughter. In the end, he chose to be better. In the end, he chose to make his own fate. In the end, he chose to stand up to tyranny. And his daughter is going to remember those choices. Those choices will affect how she chooses to live. And I think that makes Thor's final choice here worth it. Even if he doesn't live to see it, his choice here will affect the story going forward, both for his daughter and for everyone. And his narrative presence in this story could continue to be felt, even when he is no longer actually present.
Okay. Alright. Okay. Alright. That was a good video. Alright, that was a very good video. It's called Thor, the Broken God. Fantastic narration. Way too long. 36 minutes to show us how fucked up Thor and his father is. And why Thor never fucking learns how stupid he is until the ending where he actually dies. Like, what is this writing? Like, man, the Thor, you know, God of War, Ragnarok, disappointed me in a lot of ways. This is like one of the most annoying things about it. It reminded me of Last of Us Part 2, you know? The fucking Joel Miller dies, and then she goes on a revenge, and in the end, she leaves the bitch that she's supposed to kill. And in order to kill her, she killed so many people throughout the whole game. Ellie killed so many people to get to the fucking target and kill her. And she was already, like, you know, stuck to a fucking pole and about to die, but she frees her for some reason. I guess she wanted to fight one-on-one with her, but then she leaves her, lets her escape. The fuck is that? Oh, that shit is 10 times worse than this Thor's character, but Thor's character was also annoying. You know, it's just annoying, man. Okay, that's my opinion, all right? It's a one-hour fucking reaction with my shitty-ass opinions. Fucking terrible-ass opinions. I don't know. Maybe you will not like it, I guess. You might not like it, but it's just fucked up, okay? Really fucked up. Really, really, really fucked up. Okay, so, you know, fuck Thor. Just fuck him in this game. The game is just a fucking mess. Just a mess, okay? But, you know, I wanted to see more Kratos, but the ending was so good, I loved it. Okay, the ending was so good, and everything came together in the end, so it made sense. But when you're going through the whole story, and especially the middle part with Atreus and his shitty-ass love story, it just gets annoying, dude. And Thor is just annoying. With his depression mode all the time, and the mystery never gets solved. What is that green scratch? We never find out, and it's like, what the fuck, you know? So just ridiculous. All right, so Thor the Broken God, what did you think about it? Did you like my reaction? If you like my reaction, please subscribe to my channel and you know, show me support. I know this will piss you off because you know, God of War is everyone's favorite. It's my favorite too. I love Kratos. I love the ending, that where Atreus went away somewhere for a journey of his own, and Kratos has a even bigger purpose now or something, which is pretty cool. I wanted to get back to Kratos, and I'm finally getting back to Kratos. So the next God of War better be about Kratos and an adult Atreus talking like a man, and I hope we will switch between both of them and encounter something almost like something like that, you know. But it is what it is. So yeah, Thor the Broken God by Fat Bread, pretty good narration. Okay, so yeah, that's it for this reaction. Please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys later, man. Goodbye.